with Bergwijn. He knows he's too far out. He's looking for the pass. They're all covered up forward. He's going to have to bomb away. Goes for the torpedo punt kick. It's quite effective distance-wise, but just off to the right and through for a behind. It's his second score. And Devonport, look at that. Now, that tells you what discipline is all about. The man who's played in the premiership sides telling the youngster what self-discipline's all about.
That's unusual for the coach to come down to the boundary line. Usually
there's
over the phone, isn't it?
This is the failure in St Kilda. Here goes Bergwijn. Oh, he's just missed.
Maybe the rot sending in for St Kilda for Collingwood also. Kenny Sheldon on his way back to the coach's box. Mickey Bergwijn has now kicked three behind. He's had two chances in this second quarter.
Well, Devonport, two mistakes, Bernie. Wouldn't handball to Harvey and then gave away a free kick and didn't Sheldon let him know about it. Flanagan was in the front spot. It was an extraordinary scene, wasn't it, a moment ago? Burke's kick, here's a chance. Windmark. Well, a bounce. It sits up. He goes with a long bomb. Allen outnumbered. Kelly gets... Oh, Allen, magnificent. A brilliant mark. Must be paid.
Yes, definitely a mark. Kelly looked to be in the box seat, didn't he, Bruce? He looked as if he had that mark. Ball wrapped up. Let's have a look at it again. Tim Allen just getting the one hand to it and accepting it on the second bite. But there's something the defenders must do.
Ronnie McEwen looked to have him out of the contest, didn't he? And he was unable to stop him.
Exactly. Craig Kelly, well, you just have to thump it away if there's any doubt whatsoever.
But he took it to the ground. He had the ball even when he got hit the ground, Tim Allen.
It was like a basketball steal in a way, wasn't it? Shoot goal. Well, I say that with some trepidation today with St Kilda. I mean, normally this is a shoo-in, but the way they've been going, you wouldn't back them in anything at the moment. He's 20 metres out.
You'd be having taking overs, wouldn't you, Bruce?
I love the even. Swap punt, go for it, goal. 3-9-2-3. Gets back. Now Craven. McAdam. I want to be careful. Pekin, it's got to be a good kick. It is. To Morris. But well played, McEwen, to hold it up. Now McAdam's inside. Still McAdam. Bang to half forward. Lowe needs a big grab. Goes early. No free kick given. Saunders across the ground. Here's Greg. Was it touch off the boot? It was. Quick one on. Windmar on his own. Here's a goal. Well, the Saints are back because Windmar's at the goal square.
Shocking mistake by Saunders.
They could have really raffled that, couldn't they? Shocking kick across goal. Yeah, Robbo. Unforgivable, but there was Lowe, Windmar and Kickett, three players in the goal square. They could have raffled it.
Windmar to bring the Saints back within a kick, and he does. His first, St Kilda bounce back. They're far from out. Good line for Collingwood, Mickey Gafer. Anyway, Bingham and Monkhorst, they lock hands. Peard over the back. Missed by Bowie, got a bad bounce. Francis under pressure, well played. Did he scoop it? Richardson's kick. Stasevich. Still starts an important ball here. Off the ground by Burke. Chance for St Kilda. Bowie. There are options. He's caught. Fletcher under pressure. Kick it. It didn't really go 10 metres. Awkward handball. Newport attacks the goal. Low goes to ground. It bounces. Kelly will probably run it towards the boundary line. He's caught. Devonport. Craven's on his own in the goal square. Devonport puts the Saints in front. Sensational stuff here at the MCG. 80,000 people are watching a thriller. I tell you what, Bernie, he wanted to kick it because he had Craven all alone in the goal square.
What about Kelly here?
Now, what about the defensive play by Stewie Lowe keeping the ball in the forward line?
Doesn't Kelly get dragged off the footy here in that
match? He has the ball in his possession here, Robbo, dragged off. Stewie Lowe let him go there. Well, I think it is.
Critical bit of play coming up now, because if the Saints score a goal, you'd fancy that win for sure in the context of this game at 75-77.
Very important. Bingham, Tony Shaw, just gets his right foot to it. Kicks it back near the centre. This is a critical position. Francis, quickly. Morwood, fresh player. What can he do with this kick? Up to centre half forward. Oh, knocked out of it.
Oh.
And he made it.
Oh,
there's nothing in that.
Oh, I thought a good mark there by Russell Morris.
Well, he just nudged him a little bit, but there was nothing in it.
Oh, gee, I cannot believe that one.
Oh, dear me. Now, Watson can score a goal.
nothing in it.
Nothing in it whatsoever.
A critical decision.
Very ordinary with under 3 minutes left. Here goes Watson. He gets underneath it. And he kicks a behind. Well, probably all it deserved. Shane Watson, one goal, two. St Kilda lead by a point, and look at the anxiety in the coaches' boxes.
Well, I'm not sure it even deserved a behind in that in the long run there. Let's have a look at the free kick again. Russell Morris in better position. I don't think he even hardly touched him.
Got a good view of that, didn't we? 1 point the difference. Morris with a long run, and why not? Moncourse, Morwood at the back. Bingham, Devonport, a good handle to Greg, to Newport, to Bowie, sweeps it out wide, to Pekin. Short drop punt low, no free kick. Gee, St Kilda had a chance there, they were running. Now Francis from half back. Burke getting back, Stasevic, well played Burke.
Lost two, Bruce.
Well, Tim Pekin could have kept running around that outer wing, Bruce. He had 30 metres in front of him. What a great option. Chipped it up where a couple of Collingwood defenders had the chance to spoil.
Burke, 23-6, and a great effort then against a man much taller.
Craven had a terrific last quarter. Gregan, oh, good mark. Gee, he's been a good player, Greg.
Look at those stats, Bruce. 15 kicks, 12 handballs. Coming in for his 16th kick, he's taken 7 marks, a couple of telling marks in this last quarter.
Gee, this is a big call, isn't it? To McAdam. Saunders held up, St Kilda still have it. Craven, oh, McAdam gave it away. Craven caught, is he gone? He's crunched to the ground. Collingwood win it. White, Burke, also with him, Saunders. They throw themselves on it. Gee, the Greg. Gee, can you take a chance, Greg?
What do you do that for with such short time to go in the game?
Well, there's a minute and 20 seconds remaining, and St Kilda lead by point. Bingham's tap, Collingwood through McGuan. Williams, the pressure on him. McAdam, well played to Newport, who's got fresh legs. Newport goes into the centre. What a ball here.
Tell you what, Greg has done very, very well. Bernie's picked that. Morris, Greg, Morris, Watson the tackler. Morris does well, handballs it to his own advantage. Pushed off the ball by Watson, goes after it again. Well done, Russell Morris.
And that's
excellent football.
Delivered in the end. Robbo, he's very lucky to get away with that. He fumbled it. Look
at
this.
What can you do, though?
Oh, he goes directly for the boundary line and just taps it over.
Oh, come on, Bernie.
Oh, looked initially, Robbo. Looked
Sean
very
Francis.
Pretty blatant.
Back near the centre. Devonport. Saunders. Still Collingwood a chance. Williams, he's caught by Pekin. Out the back, kick it. St Kilda will win. Kick it into the centre. Harvey marks. 17 seconds left. Harvey, short kick. Mark to Bingham. And the big Lawrence Bingham may have the last kick of the game. Take your time, son. Oh, he thumps it inside 50. No mark. Fletcher. Chance for Craven. And look at the Saints fans. Oh, what a great win. Now, this will help St Kilda like you wouldn't know, Bruce.
Well, it's going to be one of the great games. There's no question about that. Ironically, the same scoreline as in 1966, 1 point margin. A similar score. I think that was about 10-14 to 10-13 that day. So very similar. It was one of the bravest matches you could ever see. It had 80,000 people. It had a big build-up. The two teams went in with their two superstars missing, Dacos and Lockett, and they produced a game that everybody who's been here today will remember for a long, long time.